Hey everyone, this is Dayu from Ecom Ops. Today we're going to talk about China's supply chain planning for Q4, the fourth quarter in e-commerce. We're going to talk about why it's so important to think about your supply chain the right way. If you're fulfilling from China, whether you're dropshipping or you have an e-commerce brand, we're going to talk about some key dates you should definitely be aware of and plan around. And we're going to talk about some general tips to get through Q4 successfully. Now, following up on this video, in the next week or so, we're going to launch another video that's a little bit more advanced and detailed in how we actually think about detailed step-by-step supply chain planning as a framework if you're scaling up in Q4. So definitely check out that video in a week or so as well. And by the way, we're going to add a module in our completely free Ecom Ops supply chain course as well. So if you haven't gotten it yet, definitely check out the information and link below. All right, let's get started. So first, let's talk about why is Q4 China supply chain planning so important. So first, on the demand side, as most of you probably know already, Q4, which is October, November, December, but really focused around November and December, are the biggest holiday sales periods really around the world, especially in the Western countries. People are shopping for Christmas gifts. They're just generally in a buying mood, even if they're not buying gifts. And most e-commerce brands are going to have a significant, if not majority, of their sales during this time, and it tends to be some of the most profitable as well. Now, particularly if your product is a great fit for a gift, or is more of a holidays product, or you have some kind of messaging, marketing angle around it being the holidays, there's going to be extreme pressure for your fulfillment to deliver these products, these orders, on time for Christmas. And if you don't, and you promise it, you're gonna have a lot of issues with your store. There are going to be a couple of unfortunate realities that are gonna happen during Q4 on the China supply chain side. So first of all, factories get incredibly busy during this time because of all that increased demand. So just everything is slower, lead times are longer. Second, all logistics gets slower around Q4. I mean, not just China logistics, but also local logistics as well. Everything just gets a little bit slower, which obviously timing really matters if you're targeting Christmas delivery. And then finally, prices in terms of shipping costs all tend to go up in Q4 as well because of that increase in demand and simply just not enough increase in capacity. So if you do not plan ahead, especially if you have a Christmas product or promising Christmas delivery, you're gonna have to face two very significant risks. The first risk is that you're gonna have a lot of packages not delivered by Christmas, which means chargebacks, refund requests, and I've seen very promising stores just get crushed and shut down even because of this. And even if you're relatively luckier, you're gonna wipe a lot of your profits off your table because of all those chargebacks and refunds that you're gonna receive. And then the second is that if you don't actually plan for your supply chain correctly, particularly your inventory, and you run the risk of seriously running out of stock and you can't get more in time. Now, if you decide to be more conservative and don't want to market when you don't have stock, well, that means you have a lot of money then potentially left on the table. Now, remember, opportunity cost is a cost as well. So if you're not able to take advantage of the best sales season of the year, you could be, I mean, I've seen stores put like, you know, six figures on the table or even more simply because they don't have the stock to be able to market in those last weeks of holiday sales. Now, supply chain issues aside, there's also a couple of things you should be aware of. Is first, Facebook these days, they're going to have limits on how fast you can scale up your ad account, especially if it's a relatively newer ad account without that much scale before. And then second, PayPal, other types of payment providers, they are going to potentially hold or freeze your account if you scale up too hard, too fast. So those are considerations as well going into Q4, when most likely you're planning to scale up and most likely you will succeed if you know what you're doing. Now let's talk about some key date ranges to be aware of and how you should plan around it. So starting in Q4, right dab at the start of it, is in China what's called the Golden Week holiday. So it tends to be October 1st, 4 days to 7 days or so, depending on the factory or the supplier. So this is officially the start of Q4, and it's a time when your supply chain is just going to be off for between 4 to 7 days. Now this is not really something you need to worry too much about, because early October is not really the key sales season yet, but this is actually the start of Q4, and you should be aware of these holidays and you know, how we plan around it, which we'll actually detail in the next video. But you know, this is when we start planning around more detailed supply chain plans. And then after the first week, after the holidays, so between early October to mid-November, this is a period where everyone starts ramping up, including factories, and factories start really solidifying and planning for what their Q4 production capacity is actually going to be. Do they add more assembly lines? Do they add more people, for example? And this is where you're going to be scaling, and this is where you need to be working with a supplier who knows what they're doing and communicating with them and make sure that they're going to scale successfully with you. So this is actually one of the most critical parts of Q4, because this is going to be that first phase when you actually scale up. And then next is Thanksgiving in the US and Black Friday, Cyber Monday sale. So Thanksgiving every year is the fourth Thursday of November, and after Thanksgiving, or actually the sales tend to start actually even before Thanksgiving, but that weekend is Black Friday, Cyber Monday sales, and that is going to be the biggest spike in retail sales and e-commerce sales. I mean, it is the biggest sales holiday of the entire year, at least in the Western countries. And this is going to be where you see a huge spike in your sales. And this is where you should probably plan for a huge spike in your sales as well. If you make a lot of sales around this time, there should be still enough time, depending on what shipping method you use, obviously, there should be still enough time to actually fulfill those orders in time for Christmas. So it's a pretty good time, actually, because it is a time that you probably want to plan for stock in advance, probably want to plan for fulfillment in advance. You're going to be confident about your product, and hopefully you're going to make huge sales. And if you plan accordingly, those sales are going to be able to be fulfilled by Christmas, and you'll be able to guarantee Christmas delivery for those sales, again, if you plan accordingly. And then the next major key date range to keep in mind is early December. This is going to be, if you're fulfilling from China, anywhere between the last days of November to maybe December 10th or so, depending on what shipping method that you use, these are going to be the last shipping day cutoffs if you are going to fulfill from China and you want your products to arrive to your customers by Christmas. So this is a very, very crucial time, because you tend to really want to make sure that you have a plan, you have stock ready, you can fulfill as fast as possible so that you can market to the very last day possible in terms of the shipping cutoffs for each specific country, which, by the way, they're going to be different. Each country and each shipping line is going to be different as well. So this is something we'll talk about more detail in the next video. And then there's going to be a period between mid-December to Christmas or Christmas Eve. So there's actually a general misconception a lot of time that if you cannot ship in time for Christmas, then it just, like, your sales are going to plummet. So that is actually not true. So every single year, we actually see continued strong sales from our clients, even after they cannot deliver by Christmas. By the way, don't promise them it'll be by Christmas, right? Even if it won't arrive by Christmas, people are still going to be purchasing all the way through, usually around Christmas Eve or so. So again, don't just think that your sales are going to drop off. If you have stock that you planned, you can still try to push it out. It's still going to be probably profitable as well. What typically happens is that, you know, people are still kind of in that shopping mood going into Christmas. At this point, as long as you message it correctly, they know it's not going to arrive by Christmas. However, they might be still buying a gift for themselves. They might just again, still being the mood. So that's why the sales continue through Christmas Eve. And then obviously after Christmas, well, between Christmas and January, there obviously is still time before Q4 actually ends, but that is officially the end of the actual sales season. Usually between Christmas and New Year's Eve, this is a time where I actually suggest clients like, hey, look, you know, if you crushed it, if you worked hard in Q4, you probably did not have much rest. And that is a time for you to celebrate, hopefully celebrate your big sales and refresh and head into the next year, Q1 strong with, you know, the same product or start testing new products and testing new brands. So now to talk about some general tips for getting through this period successfully. By the way, again, there's gonna be a more advanced video next after this, but these are just some general tips you should think about. So first, right now when this video launches, it's gonna be mid to late September or so. So you wanna be going into Q4 making sure that you have a validated winner, which means that as early as possible, honestly, ideally you should have a validated winner by now, but you still have some time. So if it's still September for you right now, or maybe early October, you really want to get on testing. You want to make sure that you have a winner to scale through or a couple winners to scale through, and you want to make sure to focus on scaling them. And really just, you know, after a while, like in November, for example, you really don't want to be testing anymore. You really want to be focusing all of your efforts on scaling the true proven winners and try to get as much out of them as possible. Now, one of the things that you want to do as you actually plan for your own marketing plans in Q4 is you want to determine if your product is really something that Christmas delivery matters a lot. Now, for most products, it does actually, because a lot of people just buy gifts, especially try to guarantee it and use that as an angle. I would say that if you can guarantee Christmas delivery, try to do it, because it definitely is going to improve your conversion rates. But the thing is, like, there's gonna be a lot of products out there, like evergreen products, for example, that, like, they might work as Christmas gifts, but, you know, they don't necessarily have to be only sold in Q4, which means that obviously you don't have to just plan for as aggressively for Q4 as much, and you can plan for Q1 as well when you're thinking about stocking. On the other hand though, be aware that even if you do not plan for a Christmas delivery angle, some products are just going to have high expectations in terms of Christmas delivery. A perfect example is kids' toys. No matter like how much you want to avoid promising Christmas delivery, you're gonna have a lot of parents, a lot of family members maybe hoping for Christmas delivery, even if you don't promise it. So just be aware what kind of product, what kind of marketing angle that you're planning for going into Q4. Another tip is, and this is by the way why it's so important to try to get a validated winner as soon as possible, is that you want to start scaling that product up or those products up as early as possible into Q4. So for a couple reasons, right? In terms of like planning for your supply chain, your order volume, your sales performance is going to just improve through time, improve through late October into early November, and then it's going to spike around Black Friday, and it's going to continue to be strong through the last shipping days before Christmas. What this means is that the more that you can actually validate your product through scaling up, the more that you can kind of figure out what kind of volumes that you can actually scale up to, the better you'll be equipped to actually plan for your production, plan for your stock, and have more confidence on how much you can actually scale up during the last phases of the sales season. And the other thing as well is, you know, as I mentioned earlier, that don't forget stuff like, you know, Facebook accounts, don't forget stuff like PayPal accounts. If you all of a sudden scale up and you haven't before, PayPal might freeze and hold your funds. Facebook might just limit your scaling. So if you actually just have a spike on Black Friday, for example, you're gonna face a lot of risk on that front as well. So definitely try to test products as early as possible and start scaling up smoothly as much as possible without the spikes until obviously something like Black Friday. The next tip is that if you haven't already, please, please find a good private agent or supplier to work with if you plan to scale through Q4. I don't care if it's with us, find someone good to work with. This is not a time that you wanna use traditional dropshipping. This is not a time that you wanna use AliExpress or some dropshipping platforms that don't really plan stock for you. If you really wanna make the most out of Q4, you really have to find a good supplier. And we have a whole guide on that, by the way, in our course. So definitely check out the course if you haven't already. If you're thinking about branding or customizations, do it as soon as possible. Do it now, actually. And if it's too late, just don't do it at all. Branding and customization, they all take time. They all add to lead time. And if you're doing it too late, like in November, it's just going to really mess up your supply chain. Everything's going to take longer. You're going to probably make a lot more money if you're selling a good quality generic product with simple branding than trying to customize something in the last, you know, like weeks of November, and you're going to have no time to actually produce it anyway. So do your customization as early as possible before the Q4 peak season. Another important tip is have some cash saved up, all right? Another reason why you should be scaling up through early Q4, because when it becomes peak season, you want to have some cash to be able to, if needed, to be able to pre-stock inventory. Depends on your risk profile, really, but if you want to squeeze out as much as possible, make as much as possible, you really want to consider pre-stocking inventory, going to Black Friday, going to the last days of shipping, so that you can really make as much as possible. And pre-stocking most of the time is going to require some cash, maybe not a significant amount, but definitely expect that you want to hold some cash aside to support that. And then finally, as you're scaling up early in Q4, make sure that your marketing numbers, make sure your ROAS, make sure you have plenty of margin room. Well, partly because you want to be as profitable as possible, but also partly because, as I mentioned earlier, there are a couple of things you need to be aware of, right? First, generally speaking, shipping times are going to be slower across the board. However, some of the faster lines, for example, UniExpress Express lines, they're going to be quite consistent, actually, which means that if you really want to eke out as much as possible, you want to be considering swapping out and upgrading to better and better lines so you can ship as late as possible, but better lines are going to be more expensive. So make sure that you have enough margin to support that if that's something that you want to do. And then the second is that throughout Q4, usually starting in November or so, but sometimes earlier, especially in 2021 with COVID happening, shipping prices are going to go up. And it's just going to happen, which means that you need to be aware that especially if your product is a little bit heavier, that shipping costs are going to go up and you want to have plenty of margin to support that. Typically, if you have a winter, it's not going to be a huge problem because you know, Q4 sales are always more profitable generally if you know what you're doing. But again, this is one of the reasons why, again, test as early as possible, get a validated winner as fast as possible, get that marketing optimized, start scaling up, make sure you have plenty of margin to support all of this. That was a quick intro video on how to think about Q4 planning in general. Again, in a week or so, we're going to launch a more advanced video talking about the details of how you should think about supply chain planning at each step. So definitely check that out. And we're going to be adding more advanced modules in our course on Q4 supply chain planning and inventory planning as well. So we'll link to it below. If you like this video, you know, please like, subscribe. I really appreciate it a lot. And don't forget to join our Ecom Ops Facebook group where we share a lot of content. And actually throughout Q4, I'm going to be sharing a lot of updates in terms of shipping updates. I'm going to be probably running webinars on how to think about just Q4 planning as we go through Q4. So definitely join the group if you haven't already. All right. Well, thank you guys. Hope that was helpful. Again, this is Dayu from Ecom Ops. See you guys next time.